Dear viewer, welcome to Samuel Academy. Today I want to bring you a Bible story about Abraham, the man of faith. The story is taken from the book of Genesis, chapter 11, verse 26, to Genesis, chapter 25, verse 8. Let us begin. Abraham's father was called Terah. His mother, her name was called Amathlai. His brothers were Nahor and Haran, and Lot was his nephew, the son of Haran. Abraham lived in Ur among the Chaldeans. This is where Ur was, between the two rivers. This is the land of Chaldea and this Ur, where Abraham used to live. He had a wife called Sarah. The name was Sarai in the beginning, but was changed to Sarah. Alright. Abraham left Ur of the Chaldeans with his father, and they came to the land of Haran in Syria. So from Ur of the Chaldeans, from here, they came to Haran in the land of Syria. When he was 75 years old, Abraham departed from Haran with his wife and Lot, his nephew, to the land of Canaan. The land of Canaan is here. Okay, where we have Shechem, Beersheba, Jerusalem, and so on. Abraham came to Shechem unto the plain of Moreh, and the Lord appeared unto him there. At Shechem, he built an altar unto the Lord. From Shechem, he moved to a mountain between Beth El and Hai, and built an altar there and call upon the name of the Lord. Beth El means house of God. Abraham continued to move to the south. There was a famine in the land. Abraham moved further down into Egypt. So from the land of Canaan, Abraham went down to Egypt because of a famine. In Egypt, he feared for his life because Sarah was a fair woman to look at. So he told her to say to the Egyptians that she was his sister. The Lord plagued Pharaoh and his house with great plagues because of Sarah, Abraham's wife. Pharaoh would have taken Sarah to be his wife, but he didn't because the Lord prevented him. Abraham was sent away from Egypt. When he left Egypt, he came back to Beth El and to the place of the altar, and there he called upon the name of the Lord. There was strife between the herdsmen of Abraham and those of Lot, his nephew, because of the increase in their livestock, and the land could not accommodate them. To avoid more strife, Abraham separated from Lot, his nephew. Both had the freedom to choose where to go. Lot chose on the plain of Jordan towards the east, but Abraham dwelt in the land of Canaan. So at this point, Lot chose to go to the east in the land of Moab, but Abraham chose to go to the west in the land of Canaan. Okay. Abraham came to dwell in the plain of Mamre, which is in Hebron. And there he built an altar unto the Lord. At one time, there was war between several kings, in which Lot and his people were captured. When Abram heard this, he pursued the enemies and rescued Lot and all that belonged to him. On the way from pursuing the enemy, Abram met Melchizedek, king of Salem. He was the priest of the Most High God. He brought forth bread and wine and blessed Abraham in the name of the Lord. Abraham gave him tithes of all. Abraham refused to take gifts from the king of Sodom, lest he boast that he had made Abraham rich. Abraham had a vision. The word of the Lord came unto him, saying, "Fear not, Abraham. I am thy shield and thy exceeding great reward." The Lord promised Abraham a son that would be his heir. He showed Abraham the stars of the sky and compared Abraham's descendants to the number of the stars in the sky. Abraham believed in the Lord, and the Lord counted it unto him for righteousness. The Lord asked Abraham to offer a sacrifice to him. When the sun went down, a smoking furnace and a burning lamb passed between the pieces of the sacrifice. In the same day, the Lord made a covenant with Abraham. Abraham had an Egyptian maid called Hagar. Sarah, Abraham's wife, asked Abraham to take her as wife in order to bear children for him because Sarah was barren. Hagar conceived, but then she despised Sarah in her eyes, and so Sarah dealt harshly with Hagar until she fled from her face. The angel of the Lord met Hagar on the way and told her to go back to Sarah and submit to her. Hagar bore a son and called his name Ishmael. At 99 years, the Lord appeared to Abraham. That is when he was 99 years old. The Lord appeared to him and told him to walk before the Lord and be blameless. He told Abraham that he would be a father of many nations, and therefore the Lord changed the name of Abraham to Abraham, meaning the father of many nations. The Lord also changed the name of Abraham's wife from Sarai to Sarah, meaning the mother of many nations. Abraham was circumcised at the age of 99 years, as well as Ishmael, who was 13 years old. In the plains of Mamre, the Lord appeared to Abraham. Three men stood before him, and he received them. Right? The men confirmed to Abraham that he would have a son at the appointed time. Abraham interceded for the city of Sodom and Gomorrah before the Lord, not to destroy the righteous together with the wicked, even if only up to 10 righteous people were in the city. Abraham sojourned in Gerar in the south, and to Abimelech, king of Gerar, Abraham said of Sarah that she was his sister. Abimelech took Sarah, but the Lord warned him in a dream and withheld the king from sinning against him. The Lord commanded the king of Gerar to restore Sarah to Abraham because Abraham was a prophet. When Abraham was 100 years old, Isaac was born to him. One day, Sarah spotted Ishmael mocking her son and asked Abraham to send him away with his mother. Abraham sent them away, and they departed and wandered in the wilderness of Beersheba. The Lord asked Abraham to offer Isaac for a burnt offering, and Abram obeyed. On the way to the place of sacrifice, Isaac asked his father where the lamb to be sacrificed was. Abram replied, "My son, God will provide himself a lamb for a burnt offering." Abraham stretched forth his hand and took a knife to slay his son, but the angel of the Lord called unto him out of heaven and told him not to. When he looked behind him, there was a ram caught in the thicket by his horns. Abraham took the ram and offered him up for a burnt offering instead of his son. He called the name of the place Jehovah Jireh. Abraham married another wife after the death of Sarah. Her name was Keturah. Abraham had other children besides Isaac and Ishmael. He died at the age of 175 years and was buried in Mamre. Okay, what lessons can we learn from the story of Abraham, the man of faith? In this story, we find that Abraham loved to build altars for worship unto the Lord. That's a good example we can emulate. Building altars for the Lord, to worship the Lord, because that is why we exist, to worship and serve the Lord. He loved to offer sacrifices unto the Lord. He used to call upon the name of the Lord. He was a man of faith. He was obedient to God. He had human weakness just like us. For example, fearing for his life to the extent that he said Sarah was his sister. I'm sure this video has been a blessing to you. You can do one of the following or all of them. You can like, leave a comment, share widely, and subscribe so as to support this work of Bible stories for our children and even adults. Thank you so much.